discussed on direct was the area around tree number one, and that was back on April the 22nd?
Correct.
Would you say that you spent 20 hours looking at that area?
No.
No. Do you think you would have noticed anything if you'd looked at that same area for 20 hours?
I would think so.
Okay. Now, you were also part of the line search on the 23rd.
I was.
As part of that line search, do you pick up every leaf, twig, or piece of debris that's on the ground?
No.
Now, you're also asked about the tent site in Vermont as well. That was not in the same condition as the site near Profile Avenue?
Correct, which I, yes, it was not in the same condition.
It wasn't burned at all, was
Correct.
It? Okay, and so, and around that area there was litter?
There was.
There were Mountain Dew bottles?
There were.
Those Mountain Dew bottles weren't burned?
No.
There were rotisserie chicken packages?
There were.
Those packages weren't burned?
No.
There was an adjacent trash pile to the tent?
There was.
And there was also one that was located about 40 to 60 feet away from the tent as well?
Correct.
Now, one of the things you did in preparing was to review photographs of the scene around tree number one. Is that fair to say?
It is.
And I say photographs, I mean digital images?
Correct.
Okay. And that was of the area around tree number one?
Yes, and to include the area around
okay.
tree number one.
I'm showing you what's been admitted as State's Exhibit 45, specifically image 92 within there. Do you recognize this image?
Yes.
Okay. Is that the, did you review a digital version of that image?
I did.
Okay. And that digital image appear to be a fair and accurate representation of the area?
It does.
Okay. And it was the same in You'd reviewed that digital image as part of preparing for this?
Correct.
Your Honor, I'd move to admit what's marked for identification as State's Exhibit 292. It's a flash drive containing image 92, a digital image of image 92 from State's 45, and evidence as a full exhibit.
I think you need a bit more foundation.
Showing you a file from the State's 292. And does this appear to be the digital image of the hard copy image that you're reviewing right now?
It does.
Okay. And does it appear to be a fair and accurate representation of the scene from April the 22nd?
It does. Can you tilt the screen a little bit? There we go. Perfect. Yes.
Okay. I'd move to admit what's marked for identification as State's 292 and the evidence is 292. Flash drive containing a digital image of basically the hard copy image 92 located in States 45.
Okay. Subject to the discussion we had yesterday, 292 is a full exhibit.
Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you.
That's not Marsh Loop.
Now, I'm showing you this image. It's at 27% size right now. This is at 100%. Now, let me zoom back out here so we have the full perspective. Did you review this image?
I did.
Okay, and did you identify another area of interest in this beyond the area with the yellow flag?
I did.
Okay, and when did you do that?
Yesterday morning.
Yesterday morning?
Correct.
Okay. And what area in particular of this image did you identify as another area of interest?
Hard on the form here, but I believe it's this area right here.
Okay. And with the court's permission, I just have a very specific yes or no question.
Objection.
That was subject to our discussion from yesterday,
yes.
Your Honor.
Yes.
Okay. And again, if you would, let me ask you this. Is the object of interest that you located in this image now?
It is.
Okay, and without saying anything further about the object, I would just ask you to point it out for me, and I'm going to provide you with a laser pointer to point out to members of the jury without any further description.
Right here.
Okay, that's the object you located of interest?
Yes.
Okay. And that photograph was taken on April 22nd?
It was.
Moment, Your Honor.
Of course.
I have no additional questions. Defense counsel may have some additional questions for
you. Thank you. Further direct examination, rather.
Okay. say that you were looking at photographs yesterday morning?
Yes.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, I didn't realize that we were blocked from each other. Where is... Looking for the photograph that I showed you on direct of that flag by the tree. Huh. Not a good day.
It might be right here.
Huh?
On the table.
On the table.
Oh. Yeah. Thank you. I'm going to show you, yes, again, 1114. And is that the area of the flag where you were, is that the picture that has the flag where you were searching the stick?
Yes.
And it's tree number one, and then you go north and you have the stick.
Correct.
And the trail is right along the forefront of the photograph, right?
This, yeah, the north-south Marshall Loop Trail.
Okay. And I refresh the jury first. And the photograph that you were looking at in on cross-examination, somebody took it to you yesterday?
No.
Okay, so you were just going through the stuff and...
Yeah, so that, the photograph just shown to me on cross is the next one sequentially as one would click through from there to there.
And so it was the same area, a different image?
Correct.
And I'm going to show you a copy of, so it's just the image that you focused in on was just a little north of the big tree.
It's hard to, if not right next to it, it's hard to tell exactly where in relation to the tree, but I'd say either next to it or just south of it or just right. In my opinion, the image I viewed yesterday morning among many is basically that picture and then someone taking maybe several steps towards the stick of interest that I had identified earlier.
Okay. And, when you were there and searching all of this area, you didn't see any shiny objects on the ground, right?
I didn't.
And
well, I recant, other than the bullet fragment that I had previously located.
Thank you. There is a little bullet fragment on the south side of the tree that you saw in coagulated blood when you looked at that area after you were alerted by the canine.
Correct,
canine.
South of the tree.
Okay. And that was the only shiny object that you saw that day?
Correct.
And you were specifically looking for casing?
Again, ideally, yes.
And this was the area not only of your search, but numerous other officers?
Correct.
And metal detectors?
I don't recall on that day, but yes, on the 23rd.
And actually, specifically, I'm going to show you a copy of what is Defendant's Exhibit 1002. You recognize this area?
That appears to be south of tree number one.
Correct. Tree number one is just north of the red flag on that trail?
Yes.
And that red flag is pretty much in the area where the coagulated blood was?
Very close to.
Okay, I'd like to pull that up. And I'd like you to take a look at the red flag by tree number one, and I'm going to magnify it a bit. There is a metal detector right in that same area of the photograph that you just pulled up, right?
Yes.
Okay.
It appears to be.
So I want to... ask you about, what's the other thing? You said that if you had been in that area for 20 hours, you would have noticed something.
Notice more.
Okay. But if there were no shiny objects and no shell casings there, you could not notice them no matter how long you were there.
Maybe not those specifically, but I'd notice more of the area itself.
Sure.
Yep.
But if there were no casings, you cannot notice casings.
If they're not there, correct.
Good. Thank you.
Further cross-examination?
Just to be clear, the image on the screen, Detective Ryder, what date is that in the upper left-hand corner of that image?
That is April 23rd.
Okay, so that's the day after that photograph that I had published with you was taken.
Correct.
No further questions.
Any objection to excusing Detective Ryder altogether?
No, Your Honor.
Detective, you're free to go.
Thank you.
Thank you.